Hey there, how was doing? This is Kali from Tech Fanciers. You guys know that I have been using latest .OS 3.0 Android Pie for quite some time, actually last 2 weeks. Well, here my thoughts and depth look of this room on in-depth look episode number 17. So yeah, let's we take a in-depth look. First is first. This is official .OS version 3.0 Android Pie February security patch GSI. It's generic system image, so if your phone supports Project Dribble, then you can also can try this one. This boy is currently running on Asus Zenfone Lite L1 ZA551KL. This is low-end budget device which has 2GB of RAM and Snapdragon 430 octa-core processor. Whenever we talk about .OS, it's like unique. Best settings wise, the customization wise, and the status bar wise, it's little different. Let's start with the boot animation. It's cool and dark, but I have to say that when the .OS is coming at the end, it's like a landscape image. That's not a big issue. We can change the boot animation using some third-party softwares. Home screen, we have default quick step launcher, but I'm using CPL here. It's smooth and provides all the stock Android pixel features. In settings, we have tons of great options to work with, but here we'll check something that I like the most. First, in the display, we have the night light option. It's cool, working like a charm. You can set automatic time. It works automatically in night time, protects your eyes. Second, the theme option. It supports dark, white and new .OS theme that I like the most. Also, you have variety of QoS style tile. You can play around with it. And the navbar pulse. Nowadays, all the custom ROMs having this, but I don't get this on my default Zen UI. This is not a good comparison, but yeah, this is new one for this device. Even if you tell this is .OS and different, it's work with the Google like a Pixel device. The integration with Google Assistant is so cool and it's responsive. Even you can set the assistant to read the news after the alarm in morning. That's lit. Also, I have turned on the native quick step navbar. The flow is quick and fantastic. I actually like this ROM a lot. The performance way better than Zen UI on this device. Yes, I'm using some patches to make the ROM as a daily driver, like UltiFix, camera to API enabling, Dolby Digital RAM management fix, and the NFS injector. A lot. Those things are actually well supported on this device and this ROM. When we talk about camera to API, here the stock AOSP camera is working, but I have enabled the camera to API and I am now using Gcam on this to take some cool pictures. For video recording, I have been using open camera as the Google Cam not supporting video recording. If you are not enabled camera to API, then you can use open camera for to take pictures as well as to record your videos. It does its job well. Then the app switching. The most important thing here, it's like insane. It working like a charm even in 2GB RAM. I really impressed with the RAM management. It's quick and responsive. Important thing, the battery backup. Well, this is too good when it comes to battery backup. The battery backup is same like Zen UI. I am getting same screen on time what I got in Zen UI. It's lasting one entire day with minimal usage of YouTube, Instagram and some shots with the Gcam. I'm approximately getting more than 5 hours of SOT, and after installing NFS injector and RAM management patches, I noticed the loss of 20 to 30 minutes SOT, but the multitasking way better and improved. It's worth to lose the 20 minutes of SOT. Also, this ROM supports the swap your external storage as internal storage defaultly. This option will really helps you if you have less internal storage, but it formats the entire SD card, so take the backup and then do. Also, consider the SD card class. Try only if you have class 10 SD card, then only all apps works well and smooth. Also, the banking apps are working fine with the Magisk Hide in Magisk Manager. And I made one video that how to install Magisk on any Android. So do check that if you want to install it. After that, whenever you rotate your phone, you will see one rotation toggle in navbar to orient the display. That one of the handy feature in my opinion. For audio clarity, I was using Dolby Digital. While comparing to the Zenui, the audio clarity was little low in .ohgsi. So I tried DD, it's working fine, especially while on headphones. Well, the drawbacks. The ROM not built for this specific device, so there are some issues you could face after installing this GSI, not only on this, in most of the GSI. First, the VoLTE. The VoLTE won't work defaultly. If you have supported VoLTE patch, then you can try, or else if you have no need of VoLTE, also you can try. And the Wi-Fi hotspot won't work, be the same on all the devices. For some devices it's working fine, for some devices it's automatically turning off after some point of time, so be aware. But as of now, I haven't faced any Wi-Fi or hotspot issue. The next thing I felt as drawback is volume control. It's like all Android Pie ROM, but there is no arrow to reduce or increase the ringtone or alarm volume. For that, you need to get into the settings and then you need to make changes. It takes little bit time as it needs to open the settings for that. Also, there is no adaptive brightness, so you need to change the brightness each and every time. But this issue can be fixed by installing some third-party applications from Play Store. The duration of animation are little long, I felt, so I have reduced the timing in the developer option. You can also do it in developer option, because if you have less animation, then it will feels like it's fast. So I have here, I'm using 0.5, so yeah. And I can't find the double tap to wake up feature on this build. Maybe it might be somewhere, I don't know. It's not in display settings, start features, battery, or even in lock and security. So I think it's not in this build. That's what about this in-depth look of .OS 3.0 GSI. My view is it's well worth to take a look, or even you can use this as a daily driver when all the patches available, like in this phone, Asus Zenfone Lite L1. I really like this one, and if you are using Asus Zenfone Lite L1, just have an entire playlist of Zenfone Lite L1 development tutorial by clicking the I button which appearing right now. Also, thank you for watching. If you like this, leave a like and subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this. Now I am in search of the GSI to try next. Feel free to tell your suggestions. I always consider your thoughts and words. Always know one thing more than others.